When QUT decided to invest in science and engineering a few years ago, we were very aware of what was going on in the STEM disciplines, or what wasn't going on. In particular, that insufficient numbers of young Australians were becoming engaged with the science disciplines in primary school and in high school. And universities can't just sit around and say, why don't young people want to do science? And that's why we're here now, that's why we have the Cube, it's why we have this particular program.
Our group is the Crops for the Future group, and what we did is actually study how crops and our plants in general respond to drought stress so that we can continue to produce more food in a drying climate using less water.
Our project was called Sourcing Solar. What they did was they got to build their own solar cells and test their efficiency against the efficiency of other samples that we gave them to power a small toy helicopter.
So my project was a sensitive investigation. Started with the students starting from scratch and building their own polyaniline sensors to test for the presence of acid. And then this morning they've been making some organic compounds, and they're actually currently testing for those organic compounds using their sensors.
So the name of the project is Cold Case. It's a snapshot of what forensic anthropology and molecular biology can be in the real world. So on the first day we did a scuttle excavation. Then today we're taking a DNA sample that they collected on Monday, and we're comparing that to determine whether any of the samples we've provided to them match what they found on the crime scene on Monday.
So the project we've been working on is called Robotic Surgeons. And over the past 3 days, the students have been using robot arms controlled by Raspberry Pis to play the game Operation. The real world application of this is essentially to reduce the cost of current medical surgeries and operations.
Our project was fruitful robotic horticulture, and we had to program a humanoid robot to harvest fruit. It's been absolutely amazing. It's been a really, really good experience. I've met loads of great people. I would recommend it to absolutely everyone.
It's been awesome. Like, I made so many friends in so little time.
You get to do so many different things that you can't do anywhere else.
Incredible experience, once in a lifetime opportunity. Definitely not something to be taken for granted.
STEM camp's actually been really inspirational and kind of has guided me in what I want to do for life.
So this project was 3D printing body parts. So this poor guy has unfortunately suffered a very large skull defect here. So the students were able to model the injury site, and using 3D modelling programs, designed an implant which could be 3D printed, and then these would be able to be implanted back into the patient and help regrow the bone.
My project was Catch Me If You Can. It was a project about mathematical modelling, so it was to get to the students to see what all the math they've been learning in high school, how you can actually apply that to some real world problems.
This project is engineering in biofuels, and they're investigating different sources of fuels to use in diesel engines with more renewable technologies.
So our group is encapsulating precision. So we're getting kids to go through the compounding process. They've been making some Nurofen tablets, some melatonin capsules, making some creams and some pessaries.
This is such an amazing opportunity for the students from all over Queensland to come and experience not only QUT and what we have to offer, but also the cutting edge research that is going on here.